हेलो एवरीवन, विशिंग यू अ वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून। एम आई ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल टू ऑल? गुड आफ्टरनून अभिराम, तनु, वसंत, हाउ आर यू? गुड आफ्टरनून तरुण, आई होप You are safe, healthy, and happy. Okay, let us begin today's class with the same note that I always say. Let me mute you all. Good afternoon, Vasant. I hope you are fine. So, while you are attending this class, sit in a place where you get good network. Keep your videos off. If you have to send any message on a chat, send it on my ID Astik, or you can send it to everyone. I'll get your message. I've also allowed you to unmute yourself. So when I ask a question, you can unmute and give me the answers. Okay. Can you recollect what we discussed in the last class? What was the topic of discussion in the last class? Do we know? Do we remember that? Yes, Abhiram, we were trying to discuss relative motion. So we had seen what basically relative motion is all about. We had seen that relative motion is a motion of a body with respect to some other body. We had also seen that relative motion is not a new concept. It's an old concept. But up till now, we were studying the motion of all bodies with respect to ground or earth. But now, what we are going to do is to study the motion of one body with respect to the other body. Why we have to do this? Why we have to study the motion of one body with respect to the other body? Why? Because we see in some cases studying the motion of one body with respect to earth, the motion is very complicated. It becomes very complicated. But if we study the motion from other body, the motion looks simple. And in physics, our main aim is to make things simpler and not difficult or complicated. We're always looking to make things simpler. And that is why sometimes it becomes important that we study motion of one body with respect to the other body. That is why we need relative motion of one body with respect to the other body in some cases and not with respect to earth. We'd also seen some basic equations of motion with respect to each other, and we have written those equations. Let us write them again to have a recollection of what we did in the last class. Final velocity of A with respect to B will be initial velocity of A with respect to B plus acceleration of A with respect to B multiplied by T. This is my equation number one. I hope all of you can see this. Equation number two. Displacement of A with respect to B is equal to, can you all see this? Displacement of A with respect to B is equal to initial velocity of A with respect to B into T plus half acceleration of A with respect to B into t square. Third, velocity of A with respect to B squared is equal to initial velocity of A with respect to B squared plus 2 times acceleration of A with respect to B multiplied by displacement of A with respect to B. Equation number 4, which we'll hardly use. Average velocity of A with respect to B is U of A with respect to B plus V of A with respect to B divided by 2. These four equations are valid for constant acceleration. And here I have not used vector sign. Instead of vector, plus and minus, yes. Instead of vector sign, we are going to use plus and minus. We can make these equations on x-axis or on y-axis in case of motion in one dimension, or we can make this equation in both the axes if we are dealing with relative motion in two dimensions. What are the sign convention? It goes like this, it's positive. Goes like this, it is negative. This is equation along x. How does the equation along y look like? Upwards is positive, downwards is negative. Am I clear? Now, the question is, how do I get this velocity of A with respect to B or acceleration of A with respect to B or displacement of A with respect to B? I have the equations. But up till now, we were doing everything with respect to ground. In most of the cases, the velocities will be given with respect to ground. Then how do I get from the ground key velocity with respect to ground? If the velocity is given, how will I get the velocity or displacement or acceleration with respect to the other body? That is my prime question. That is my prime question of concern. Let us go back. And see how we started things. Now, as usual, even though we are dealing in relative motion in one dimension, the example that I am taking is from motion in two dimensions. So that we understand, if we understand relative motion in two dimension, it will mean that we have already understood relative motion in one dimension. This is my x and y axis, this is my origin O. Let us imagine that I have a point A here. I have a point A here. If I have to tell you its position of point A, how will I tell its position? To tell its position, what will I do? To tell its position, what will I do? I will draw a vector. A vector from O to A. We'll draw a vector from O to A. What will I call it? I will call it the position vector of A with respect to O. Do we remember this? We have already done this. The chapter on vectors. If I have a point A, yes, Niharika. If I have a point A, if I have to give its position from the origin, I will draw a vector from O to A, and that will give me its position with respect to O. Similarly, I have a point B. I need to give its position. How will I give its position with respect to O? I will draw a vector from O to B. What would I call this vector? Position vector of B with respect to O. So position vector of B with respect to O gives me the position of point B. Position vector of A with respect to O gives me the position of A with respect to O. Now what will I do? Well, I will draw a vector from B to A. I will draw a vector from B to A, the red one. What will be the name of this vector? Anyone? This vector will be known as? This vector is drawn from B to A. This vector will be known as what? Position vector of A with respect to B. Correct, Niharika. This will be known as position vector of A with respect to B. Now look closely. Look closely. Look at this. Look at this. Do you recognize something? Do you see something that you have already done? Do you recognize something in this diagram that we have already done? We have done it in a different perspective, but the reason or the concept remains same. Do you remember this? Where have we done this? Where, Niharika? Where have we done this? We have done this in something known as triangular law of vector addition. We have also done this in displacement. Displacement vector. Anyways, let me write this equation again. Position vector of A with respect to B plus position vector of B with respect to O. See, this B is the common part, it gets cancelled. And what do you get? You get the position vector of A with respect to O. Do we remember this? Have we done this before? Yes or no? In triangular law of vector addition, do we remember this? Do we remember this? That we had written. We had drawn vectors one after the other. And we were using triangular law. And we found out the value of the resultant. Do we understand this? So basically, position vector of A with respect to B plus position vector of B with respect to O, B gets cancelled. What I get is position vector of A with respect to O. Now, instead of O, this could have been any point. This could have been any object. So instead of writing it as O, I can write it as G. G means ground. Instead of O, it becomes G. G means ground. So how does the equation look like now? Position vector of A with respect to B is equal to position vector of A with position vector of A with respect to B plus position vector of B with respect to ground is equal to position vector of A with respect to ground. Do we all agree on this? This B will get cancelled from here. Yes or no? This B will get cancelled from here. Okay. Now I could have written this. A with A plus gen vector of B just like A one. Great. Now, I could have understood this or written this in this fashion also. If you remember, in this A and B, I will introduce G. I go like this. So basically, what I am doing here is I am writing position vector of A with respect to B. G gets in between, so it becomes position vector of A with respect to ground plus position vector of ground with respect to B. I could remember it like this. Now you must understand that position vector of ground with respect to B is a vector. Do we understand this? Position vector of G with respect to B will be negative of B with respect to G. Do we understand this concept? Negative vectors. Okay. So these are different ways in which you can write the same thing. I'm not worried of how you remember it. I'm just worried that you must remember this in whatever way you remember it. The only thing that you got to remember is position vector of A with respect to B will always be position vector of the first term with respect to ground minus position vector of the second term with respect to ground. Can you remember this in whatever way you understand? Can you remember this? Can I have some raised hands? Okay, now I'm going to make a small change in this equation and I'm going to arrive at a different equation. I'm going to write that different equation and then I'll ask you how will you pronounce or how will you say this equation. So here is the difference. Here is the change that I'm going to make. I have changed this equation. I have changed something in this equation. Ask your questions to unmute yourself and tell me what this equation means. Yes, Niharika, unmute yourself and tell me what does this equation mean now.
Hello, sir. Can you listen to me?
Yes, beta.
Sir, change in the position vector of A with respect to B.
Okay, just wait. What do you mean by a change in position vector? What does change in position vector mean, Niharika? Change in position means displacement.
Displacement of A, B. Displacement of A with respect to ground minus displacement of B with respect to ground.
Great. When I put a delta sign, it becomes change in position in respect to B. Instead of calling it so big, we can call it displacement of A with respect to B is equal to displacement of A with respect to ground minus displacement of B with respect to ground. Am I clear? Can I have some raised hands that we understand this, sir? Only Tarun has raised hand. Niharika obviously understands this. Abhiram, Nayan, Vishal, Irfan, Akshay, do you understand this better? Great. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do for the third equation? To get the third equation, I will differentiate equation number one with respect to time. I am going to differentiate equation number one with respect to time. What will happen? How will the equation look like? Can anyone tell me? I'll give you 2 minutes to think about it. What will you get? Differentiating equation number one with respect to time. So basically it looks like this. D by dt of r a with respect to b will be equal to d by dt of A with respect to ground minus d by dt of position vector of B with respect to ground. It looks like this. It looks very difficult in this way. How can I make it look more simple? Can anyone tell me what does this become? What does this become? And what does this become? Can anyone tell me? D by dt of r a with respect to b. Yes, it becomes velocity. So now my first term becomes this. My second term becomes this. My third term becomes this. Can anyone tell me how will I say this? Yes, Niharika, unmute yourself. Tell me, how will you say this?
Sir, so velocity of A with respect to B equals to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
That is correct. Velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground becomes velocity of A with respect to B. Here we have written all these equations in terms of VAB, delta RAB. Now we know how to get the values of this. One more thing remains, this term. How will I get this term? Think. Acceleration of A with respect to B. Apart from that, we have found out all the other terms. How will I get this one? How will I get this one? Anyone? Any idea? How will I get the next term? How will I get the next term? So now I will differentiate equation number 3, which is this one, with respect to time. So it looks like this, d by dt of v a with respect to b, d by dt of a with respect to g, minus d by dt of v, which is, what does it become now? Anyone? What does this give me? What does this give me? What does this give me? Acceleration. Acceleration of A with respect to B that is what I end up with. Do I make myself clear here? Am I clear? Do you have any doubts in this? Have I confused you with all these equations that are written? Do you have any problem with any equation? Please let me know. What I'll do, I'll write all these again once. Number one, RAB is equal to RAG minus RBG. I have not used vectors. If I have not used vectors, what will I use in place of vectors? What will I use in place of vectors if I have not used vectors? Anyone? I will use plus and minus. Yes, that is correct. I will use plus and minus for vectors. When plus, when minus, if it is along x, this is positive. If it is along x, this is negative. For y, positive. Am I clear? Do you all understand this? If I write this equation along x, instead of r, I can write x. If I write this equation along y, instead of r, I can write. If I write this equation along x, I can write delta x. I can write it as delta y. Are you getting my point? Yes or no? Yes or no? Here now is an example. Again, it's taken from your notes. Example number one. Please read the example. I'll give you a minute to read it. See the figure. Forward is positive, reverse is negative. You have to find the value of XBA, whatever it means, XCA, XCB, XAB, and XAC. I'll give you 2 minutes. Anyone with an answer? I hope everyone has read the question. Okay. Question number one. Here is the question. This is the original. This is also the point A. A person is standing here. Another person B is standing here. Person C is standing here. This is 4 meters. And this is 6 meters. You're supposed to find out these things. X, BA. Who will tell me what is X, BA? And how do I find it out? Anyone? Anyone who knows this, please raise hands. How do you do this? So, you have to find the position of B with respect to A. How will you get it? Position of B with respect to ground minus position of A with respect to ground. What is the position of B with respect to ground? B with respect to ground. Ground, you can call it as O. Ground, you can call it as O. Position vector of B with respect to O. This direction is positive. This direction is negative. So what is the position of B with respect to O? It is plus 4. Do we all agree on this? Position of A with respect to ground, you can call this as O. A with respect to O, A and O are at the same point. So this will be minus 0. So your final answer becomes plus 4. Am I clear? Am I clear? Okay, that was the first one. What about the next one? to A. How do I get the position of C with respect to A? 1 minute, think about it. C with respect to A, did you get it? Anyone? No one has tried this. Plus 10 meters. Yes, Niharika, that is correct. How do we get it? Please speak up. Tell me how to get it. Niharika, unmute yourself. Tell me. Abhiram, have you done this? Okay, I'll do it. Position of C with respect to A, I can write it as a position of C with respect to O or G minus position of A with respect to O or G, whatever. What is the position of C with respect to A? This is C here with respect to origin. Origin is here. What is the position? What is the position? Plus 10 minus position of A with respect to O. A and O are at the same point. That is 0. So you get the answer as plus 10 meters. Position of C with respect to O minus position of A with respect to O gives me position of C with respect to A. Am I clear? Am I clear? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this, sir? Okay. Well, today I'm just not feeling well. Just having some sort of a problem. That is why I'm taking breaks in between. I hope you understand. Just not well. So we'll try to wind up today's thing. B with respect to A, we have calculated. C with respect to A, we have calculated. What is the next one, Abhiram? C with respect to B. What is the value of X of C with respect to B? Anyone? How will I find it out? Niharika has given me the answer. It will be X of C with respect to O minus position of B with respect to O. What is the position of C with respect to O? This plus 10 minus. What is the position of B with respect to O? It is plus 4 plus 6 meters. This is the position of C with respect to B. Am I clear? Am I clear? The next is position of A with respect to B. Can anyone tell me what is this? Nyarika, Abhiram. Position of A with respect to B. -4, Nyarika, that is correct. How did you get it? Can you speak up and tell me? Don't think she can do. Yes, yes, Nyarika, tell me.
Sir, position of A with respect to B is position of A with respect to ground minus position of B with respect to ground.
So I have written B with respect to O. So what is the position of A with respect to ground or O?
Sir, it is the zero.
Zero.
Minus. Sir, it is the plus 4.
Plus 4. So my answer is minus 4 meters. Do we understand this, everyone? Position of A with respect to B is minus 4. Correct. The last one. Position of A with respect to C. Can I have the answer for this last one as well? Last one. Minus 10, Niharika, that is correct. I hope all of you are able to understand this. Can I have some raised hands? Let me understand this. Vashan, Tarun, Niharika, Vishal, Akshay, Abhiram, Nayan. Are we able to understand this, beta? Can I have some raised hands? No one understands this? Tarun, Vasant, Abhiram, Niharika. Niharika understands this. Nayan, Tarun, Abhiram, Vasant, Vishal. Okay. So A with respect to C will be position of A with respect to O minus position of C with respect to O. Position of A with respect to O is 0 minus, this is plus 10. So my answer is minus 10 meters. This is the answer that I was looking for. Okay. Do we get this? Okay. That takes us to the next part. And the next question is coming right away. Here is the next question. Example number 2. Just give me a minute, I'll get my water, I'll get my tablet. Read the question number 2 and solve it. I'll just come be back. Example number 2. An object A is moving with 5 meter per second. B is moving with 20 meter per second in the same direction, which is positive x-axis. We are supposed to find the velocity of B with respect to A and velocity of A with respect to B. I hope all of you have read this question. Let's have some solutions. Can I have some solutions here? Question number 2. This is velocity of A with respect to ground. It's plus 5. Velocity of B with respect to ground. Plus 20. You are supposed to tell me what is the velocity of B with respect to A. Can anyone tell me? How will you find it? Can anyone tell me what is the answer? Velocity of B with respect to A, or how will you do this? Anyone? Nayan, Abhiram, Akshay, Vishal, Niharika, Tarun, Vashant, anyone? No one knows the answer? No one knows how to do this? Let me help you out. Velocity of A with respect to B will be simply equal to velocity of B with respect to A will be equal to velocity of B with respect to ground minus velocity of A with respect to ground. Just put the values, get the answer. What is the value of velocity of B with respect to ground? You can see from here, plus 20. It is not meters, Niharika, it is meter per second. Minus, what is the velocity of A with respect to ground? You can see, plus 5, plus 20, minus plus 5, plus 15 meters per second is the velocity of B with respect to A. Do we get this? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this? Raise hands. Great. Abhiram, can you tell me the solution for the next one? Velocity of A with respect to B, Abhiram. Can you unmute yourself and tell me how to do this? Okay, he cannot unmute today. Anyone could tell me how to do this? Niharika, unmute yourself. Tell me how you've done this.
So, sir, velocity of A with respect to B equals to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
Velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground. What next?
So, velocity of A with respect to ground is
how much?
Plus 5, sir.
Plus 5.
And velocity of B with respect to ground is plus 20.
Plus 20.
It gives us minus 15 meter per second, sir.
Velocity of A with respect to B becomes minus 15 meter per second. And there is one thing that you can understand, and you actually know it beforehand also. What do you understand and what do you know beforehand? Do you see this relation? What I want to say? Velocity of A with respect to B is negative of velocity of B with respect to A. Isn't it so? Did you know it beforehand or not? We had known it beforehand, and here we can also see that both are coming same. Am I clear? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this, sir? Good. Well done, beta. Well done. With all the things that are happening today, I am not feeling well. Just not feeling well, but still, I'm very happy that you are giving your best. I am also trying to give your best. You give my best. You can see again, I'm making stupid mistakes today because I don't know. I'm just not feeling well. My head is spinning like a top. Anyways, the last question for today, that is what we have to do. And this question is coming right on your screens right now. Again, this question is taken from your notes. So we'll do up till example 3. And 4, 5, and 6, the example after this, 4 on your screen now, 5 and 6. You'll have to do it as homework. You have to do this as homework and put the solution in the Telegram group. Can you do that for me? 4, 5, and 6. Do it on your own and put the solution in the Telegram group. Can I expect this from you? Well, here is example number 3, question number 3 that we got to do in the class. Two objects A and B are moving towards each other with velocity 10 and 12 as shown in the figure. 10 is forward, 12 is backwards. Find the velocity of A with respect to B. Find the velocity of B with respect to A. Waiting for your answers. Well done, Aligram. You have given me the first answer. While I was drinking my water, you have given me the answer. So it's my humble duty to solve the question myself. And I will take the help of Aligram. Aligram can't unmute himself. So probably Niharika or someone else who has done this question will help me in solving this. Let me first write the question first. Abhiram has given me both the answers. Well done, Abhiram. So this is ground. This is body A with respect to ground. It is moving with a velocity of plus 10 plus because it is forward. Velocity of B with respect to ground, minus 12 meter per second. Niharika, unmute yourself and tell me the first answer. The first question is velocity of A with respect to B. Tell me how to do this, Niharika.
So velocity of A with respect to B equals to velocity of A with respect to ground minus velocity of B with respect to ground.
Well done.
So the velocity of A with respect to ground is plus 10.
Plus 10.
And velocity of B with respect to ground is minus 12.
Minus 12.
So the velocity of A with respect to B is plus 22 meters per second.
Plus 22 meter per second. I have given you an example of the train coming in opposite direction. Example. For example, let us say Abhiram is sitting in this train. And Niharika is sitting in this train. Now, what we have calculated just now is A with respect to B, Abhiram with respect to Niharika. That means if Niharika is in the B train, what does Niharika see? Abhiram's train coming towards her train. She sees that Abhiram's train is coming with a velocity of plus 22 meter per second. It is coming very fast. but her train is moving very slow. Niharika feels that Abhiram's train is moving very fast, but Niharika's her own train is moving very slow. पीछे वाला ट्रेन, you will see that आगे वाला ट्रेन, the सामने वाला ट्रेन is moving faster. What happens to the other one? Other one means what is the velocity of B with respect to A? B with respect to A means how does Abhiram sees Niharika's train coming to him? Niharika, what is the answer for B with respect to A? How do you do it? Tell me.
So velocity of B with respect to A equals to velocity of B with respect